The next question is it permissible to land at Jeddah Airport without ihram? Then go to Mika and rest for a day, and next day go to Makkah for Umrah.
The Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, when he named the mawaqit, هن لهن ولمن أتى عليهن من غير أهلهن ممن أراد الحج والعمرة. These locations are forever whoever passes through them who is not from their residency, who wants to perform Hajj and Umrah, meaning that you cannot pass them and do Ihram if you want to make Hajj and Umrah. So if someone is coming from Kuwait, where is your miqat? Taif, or known as As-Sail Al-Kabir or Wadi Mihrim. This is your miqat. So when you come and you come on your flight and you land in Jeddah, did you make ihram? No. You stay 2 days, 3 days, visit the locality. Then when you want to go to Mecca, you drive all the way to Taif. You wear your ihram, whether from Jeddah or from Taif, it doesn't matter. Once you reach the miqat, you say, Labbaik Allahumma Umrah. And you drive another half an hour Mecca, make your Umrah. You're solid, good. You had not done anything. You want to make your ihram from the airplane? That's even better. But either way is halal. What is not halal is for you to come to Jeddah and assume your ihram from Jeddah. Or say, I will go to Masjid Aisha. In Tan'een, and make my ihram from there. This is not permissible. Why? Because you passed over the miqat, so this is the miqat you have to go to. Tayyib, okay, if I come to Jeddah, and then I go to Medina, and on the way from Medina, I make my ihram from Abyar Ali, known as Dil Hulayfa. From Medina itself, miqat of people of Medina. Is this valid? This is okay. Because it's far, far further than your own miqat, and you are intending Umrah while passing by a valid miqat. So I hope this answers your question.